thanks for watching this video. Welcome to my next video, and this is about Windows 8.1, and Microsoft is supporting Windows 8.1 updates up until 2023, so we've got 3 more years. It's almost 2020, it's the end of 2019, so 3 more years of updates for Windows 8.1. And I have Windows 8.1 Professional, and Windows is not making it easy for people that want to reinstall Windows 8.1. I guess they want everybody to upgrade to Windows 10, and but I'm sticking with it, and I think that Microsoft should support, make it easy for people to reinstall Windows 8.1. But it isn't, so I'm going to walk you through what you have to do to get everything working. What you're going to find is that you're going to install Windows 8.1, and then you're going to run into the problem where it doesn't update. It stops updating. And so you can do a bunch of Google searches, but I'll make it easier for you. And then there's KB3173424 and KB3172614. So go ahead and search for those two things. So when you copy it and you do a Google search for each one of those, let's do the first one first. So here, it's an update for Windows 8.1 64-based systems. And if you have 64-based Windows, this is what you need to do. Install this one. So just download it and install it. And make sure all your other programs are closed before you do it. And then install it. Some people say that you have to not have Windows Update running. So what they do is they set downloads to never. And so you might have to do that to get it. But I didn't have any problems. So you just reboot and then do this update, and it'll do independently. And I just left my computer for a while. I think it was like 15, 20 minutes. And eventually it installed it. And then I Google search for the next one, and KB3172614, and do that. Get them both from Microsoft right here. Make sure you're getting them from Microsoft. Install them both, and then your Windows should update properly. And then, yeah, there's another issue that you might have, and that's the issue that I had. And what happened was that you'll be installing your updates, and my advice is to install just like 5 at a time. So you go to Windows Update, and then you install, you'll get a whole list of like 150 updates. And so you install 5 and then go to the next 5. And what happens is you might find you had the problem that I had, was is that you go to install the next 5 updates, and your computer will ask you for administrative privileges to do the install of the updates. So what happens is there's no way to fix that. So what you have to do is you have to go click on installed updates, and then uninstall the last. So go click on that, like right click on it, go uninstall. So uninstall 3 at a time, like this one, and this one. So, and then reboot it, and then uninstall another 3 and reboot it. And then you'll find, and after each time, you know, check your Windows updates until you've uninstalled all of the updates that have caused a problem. Like there might be 1 or 2, and then reboot it. And once your Windows update, and there's another tool too that you have to run too, and there's called this Windows Update Troubleshooter. So you can get it for Windows 7 and 8, and you know, use this. And it's called a diagnostic Windows Update.diagcab. So run that. It's a little program, and that'll fix some issues for you as well. So it'll fix those issues. So fix the issues. See, it says Windows Update Troubleshooter. And so just click next and run it, and it'll fix some issues for you that are, you know, broken in your registry or whatever. And that comes directly from Microsoft.com. And then when you're doing the Windows updates, find the updates that gave you the problems and don't reinstall them. So when you finally get it working again, you'll have these like four or five updates and just don't install them. And even take a video, like a photograph, and to make sure you're not reinstalling them. So once your Windows update's working again, you'll get this whole list of 150 updates or whatever. And then install every other update except for those five or whatever that were giving you the issues. And then you'll go through the whole list, you'll install everything, and everything should go without a hitch. And then once you've done that, you'll still have five that you didn't install. And then click on auto updates. Change it to do it automatically. Set it for update to automatically. And install updates automatically, and then reboot your machine. And you'll see what happens is that everything will be working, and those problem updates will just go away. They won't be there in the list anymore, and everything should be working as it should. So I hope that helps somebody. Thanks for watching.